Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of MongoDB, that is version 8 on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a sample database on our MongoDB, then how to create collection, how to insert data onto your collection, all of that on this video. So I can guarantee you this video is going to be very interesting. So to watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment me on our comment sections and also on Instagram now. So you can always ask me over there with your screenshots and everything. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install MongoDB, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and then you need to search over here MongoDB download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.mongodb.com as a first search result. So to click on this MongoDB community server download and it's going to redirect to the official site of MongoDB, and here you can see that all these different products are available to download. Starting from MongoDB Atlas to MongoDB Enterprise Advanced Community Edition and all that. I'll always recommend you download the Community Edition. If you are a student especially, then you can use it. So to download MongoDB Community Server, you need to click on this and then you need to scroll down under MongoDB Community Server Download. And you will see this download link over here. So our latest version is version 8. So if you click on that, you will see all the older versions here as well. So I'm going to download the latest one. So I'll select the first one and I'm going to download it for Windows x64. So I'm going to select this, or else if you are installing it in some other, you know, VMs or other operating system, then also you can select all these different options. All right. So I'm going to select for Windows x64. And it will be a MSI package. If you want to download as a zip, that also can do, but I recommend you for Windows you can just simply download the MSI one. So just select MSI and click on the download button and immediately we'll see that our MongoDB is rightly started downloading. So now that I already have MongoDB downloaded, so I'll cancel this and minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that our MongoDB is already been downloaded over here, version 8. So total file size is 712 MB. So once you have MongoDB downloaded, just simply double click on the software and there you go. You can see that our MongoDB installation wizard is rightly opened over here. So let's first minimize our download directory and here you need to just simply click on next. So these are all terms and conditions. You can always read this, accept the license agreement and click on next. So here under the setup type, it has given you a couple of options. One is complete installation or custom installation. You can always do complete installations. I always recommend to do that. Just simply click on complete installation and that's going to show you this service configuration page. So it's going to also install a MongoDB as a service. So it's going to do that along with this installation. You don't need to do anything. And the service name going to be MongoDB, which is totally fine. And this is going to be our data directory and this is going to be our log directory. So everything is properly set. Just simply click on next. So now we can see it's going to also install our MongoDB Compass. So MongoDB Compass basically will give you a graphic user or the GUI interface. So there you can create your collection database, you can insert data, you can import data as well. Everything you can do over there. So they have created very beautiful, you know, GUI. So you can use that. I'm going to show you on this video itself. You don't need to worry. So you need to just, you know, keep this default. So this install MongoDB Compass need to be checked and click on next. So now it is ready to be installed. Just simply click on install and there you go. It's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes and you can see that our installation is rightly began. So, you know, let's wait for some time, a couple of minutes. So by the time our MongoDB gets installed, I request you, please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So if you subscribe this channel, I'll be highly motivated. Along with, if you want, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. Now let's wait for a minute over here. So welcome back. I now can clearly see that our MongoDB is rightly installed along with MongoDB compose is also opened over here. So everything is fine. Just simply click on finish. So our MongoDB compose is also opened over here. Let's click on start. So this is the interface of our latest version of MongoDB compose. So let's first maximize it. And here to create a new connection, you can always click on this add new connection. So that's going to show you this MongoDB URI, that is MongoDB localhost 27.0.17. So everything is fine. You can just simply click on connect. So that's going to establish our connection with localhost, this port number. So it is rightly connected. So here, if you click on this localhost 27.0.17, you will see all these different databases, that is system databases, are already been over here. So now to create a new database, you need to just simply click on this create database. Here you need to provide your database name, collection name. So let's provide it one by one. So let's create a database called players db, and let's create a collection name probably called, let's say, chess player. And just simply click on create a database. So we can see that our players db is rightly created, and our chess players is our collection name. So you can insert more data over here. So you need to click on this add data over here. And if you already having one JSON file or a CSV file, so you can always click on this import JSON or CSV file, and you can import it, you know, and browse, and you can import. Or else you can insert your own data as well. So for that, you need to click on this insert document, and you need to go to this hamburger icon, and you need to hover over this ID, and you will see a plus icon over here. So to click on that and click on add field after ID, and here you can put something like player ID, let's say, give a tab, give some value, probably 1. Then you can again hover over this plus icon, you can click on add a field after player ID, and let's give something called name, and let's give the value called probably Vishyanand. Right, you can click on insert. So you can see that our data is slightly inserted over here. You can always click on this clone icon, this clone icon, so that's going to, you know, use the same template that we have used previously. Go to this hamburger icon. If you want to edit anything, let's say you want to this time make it 2, and this time you want to give D Gukesh. So our future world champion, maybe, let's say D Gukesh, insert. So you can see D Gukesh is also inserted along with Vishyanand, our former world chess champion. Anyway, yeah, so that's how you do that. You can always edit. If you need to click on this edit document, and you can, you know, edit anything. If you want to edit this, you know, your old data, you can cancel. You can also create a, click on this copy to clipboard, so our data is now copied. You can paste it anywhere. If you want to delete it, that also you can do. You need to click on this remove document, and that going to remove this data as well. All right, so in this way you installed latest version of MongoDB. You can start working on all of your projects that you have got from probably your school or college, and you can start working on that. You can ask all of your doubts on comment sections on our Instagram account as well. I'm definitely going to help you. And also don't forget to subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script vlogging channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.